Hi friends, let's talk about what's happening in React and the future of React applications. This video is really important that because there are some major changes in the React world, and I see many confused people asking questions like how to create React apps, should we use plain React or a framework, is React dying, should I use server-side or client-side rendering, and many other questions. So let's start with the installation. As you know, the React team released the new documentation last March, and we were also excited because we knew the beta documentation was great, and we were expecting some updates on how to create new React applications, because some people were complaining about Create React App, that it's too slow, it's outdated, there should be something new. And we thought they would update the Create React app or recommend using Vite instead. But after the new documentation was released, something surprising happened. Because on the installation page, they now recommend using a framework instead of the pure React library. I should admit that I was surprised too. Of course, I knew that server-side rendering was getting popular and React team was supporting Next.js. But anyway, in those days, the only thing people were talking about was Vite versus Create React App. And now, in the official documentation, they recommend using a framework. Just in this last paragraph, it says how to use it without any framework, and even here, they don't show how to do it as they do here. Well, for developers who already know React, it makes sense because now we know the feature vision of the React team. Obviously, it's the server-side rendering, and we can understand their concerns explained here. But when it comes to beginners and developers who are creating some React apps but aren't quite into frameworks, this page might be a little bit confusing. I know that because I'm getting many questions and I see many posts on the social media and people seem to be lost. They are like, wait, I am trying to learn something already difficult to me and now I have to learn a harder thing. Of course, it's not true, because in any case, you are using React and its features. Moreover, if you are using a framework, most of the features are out of the box. But I don't blame them because they don't know that yet. It's not exactly the same thing, I know, but it's like recommending TypeScript to a JavaScript learner and explain to them why they should use it and what are the possible difficulties they might face. And you can convince them and technically they can learn TypeScript, but for me, the best way to understand why one option is superior to the other is use both and observe their strengths and weaknesses. Then it's easier to make a choice and compare options. And the same thing for here. In my opinion, they should first use plain React, make some small applications, and try a framework and be able to say, okay, I'm using React rather DOM, but Next.js does this using the only app directory. Or, okay, I've learned how to split the code to reduce the bundle size, but doing this for each page is annoying. Maybe I should use a framework. And the same thing for other features, like data fetching or search engine optimization. So they should understand why they are using what they use. Basically, I will humbly recommend that the React team update the installation page and make it more beginner-friendly, and add here a guide on how to create client-only React apps. I know they have a learning page, and it's great, it's interactive, and easy to follow, but at the end of the day, people want to install it on their computers and create some small applications. I think the best way is adding here a different installation command and give some options that people can choose. It can be a framework option with the recommended label, but also a plain React app using Vite. So users can choose whatever they want. But which one should we choose? A framework or plain React? But before that, I want to answer this terrible question. Absolutely not. Not even close. Actually, it's still the most popular library. So let's check the latest JavaScript survey. And in this page, we should check two sections, the usage rate and the retention rate. The usage page shows the percentage of JavaScript developers who use these libraries and frameworks in those time periods. And as you can see, it's still on the top, and it means there are many apps built with React, and this is why React has more job opportunities than others. And if you check the retention, which is the percentage of the developers who use these libraries and still want to use them, as you can see, it's 83%, which is pretty high. Of course, it's declining, but it's totally normal. If you don't count these new libraries because there are not enough applications built with them, you will see that all frameworks are declining. But the important point is the difference between years. 1%, 4%, 1%, it's quite good. It shows that beginners can start learning React today because people love creating projects with React, and there will be tons of new tutorials and courses on the internet. But if you check the Angular here, it doesn't look so good. And starting to learn Angular might not be the best idea. If you're an Angular developer, you can still find a job. But if you're a beginner, you probably should learn something else. By the way, I said all frameworks are declining, but there's an exception here. People really love Svelte, and it's getting more and more popular. I personally want to learn also, and I wonder what you think. Just let me know your opinion about Svelte in the comments. And let's check the rendering frameworks. And as you can see, Next.js is the most popular. And after the new React documentation, probably it will blow up this year. And in the retention, again, 1% difference, it's quite good. But Next.js just released the stable version of the app directory, and it makes coding much easier and more fun. So I expect this number will increase by the end of the year. And finally, let's check the build tools. Of course, most of the apps are still using Webpack, but look at this jump here. It's almost 20%, and people really love Vite. And in the retention section, it's on the top. And we could say that using Webpack is not a good idea anymore. This is what Create React App was using. For small applications, it's okay, but when you don't configure your Webpack for the large applications, the development process might be really difficult. And if I remember correctly, Next.js is using SWC. So as you can see, nothing is dying. Actually, I hate this word. I know influencers and bloggers like giving sharp titles to get attention, like it's dead, don't use it, stop using it, but it's just not for me. So let's talk about what to choose. If you're a beginner, I've already told you my opinion, but if you know React and you are confused what to choose, firstly, I want to say there is nothing to worry about. React and React frameworks are not different things. At the end of the day, we are still writing React events, React hooks, and all the React features. But the main difference is you won't be using React Router DOM anymore. Instead, you will use the app directory to create folders to define routes. And the other major difference is rendering pages and components. Normally, React renders them on the client side. It means when you visit your website, the server receives the request and sends an empty HTML file and a bunch of bundled JavaScript. And your browser processes those bundles and renders the final HTML file. So the initial page load speed of the application can be slow because of this process. Of course, we are talking about a large project that has a really big bundle size. It doesn't mean every app is slow. And since the page is built on the user's browser, search engines cannot index websites properly. But on the server-side rendering, when you visit the website, the server receives the request and renders the HTML page and sends that to your browser. So if you have an old computer or phone, it's really good because your browser doesn't have to render everything from scratch. So it shows the initial page faster. But since everything happens on the server side, you won't be able to interact with the user. If you want to create an event, you have to create a client-side component. So if you have a highly interactive website, it might be really annoying. Basically, choosing SSR and CSR depends on your project. It's funny because 10 years ago, people were using server-side websites and client-side rendering started to become really popular, and the developer platforms and blogs had full of discussions. After the new frameworks, people started creating web applications instead of regular websites. and user interaction was the new trend. These apps and the progressive web apps were believed to be the future of the web development. And after years, here we are. Trends are changing, technologies, libraries, and frameworks are changing, but one thing remains the same: the obligation of adaptation. This is the worst part of being a developer. We have to learn every day. We can't be stuck on any technology or any idea. We have to learn as much as we can. So when it comes to using plain React or its framework, my recommendation is use both. If you have a small single page application, a website with a couple of pages, or a portfolio website, there will be no big difference between them. For example, I created this website using React and Next.js, and as you can see, there is almost no difference. So you can use React with Vite. Or if you have an admin dashboard that doesn't require SEO and has many interactive components, again, you can use Vite. But if you are creating a large application with many data fetching, many different pages like an e-commerce application, or if SEO is important for your website like a blog application, I highly recommend you to use a framework. And again, don't worry, if you already know React, it will probably take 1 week to learn a framework. It's not like moving from Java Spring Boot to Express.js or something. So keep creating small apps using all of these technologies, and when you get any project, you should be ready to deal with it using Next.js or Remix or regular React. And don't fall into what to do trap. Just be organized, be a learner, be an explorer, and don't forget, there is no perfect language or framework. It's up to you to choose the best according to your needs. Okay guys, that's all for today. Let me know your opinion in the comments. I really wonder what you are thinking about the future of React, and I'd appreciate if you could like this video. It's really important to me. And don't forget to follow Lama Dev's social media accounts. I hope I will see you in the next video. Goodbye.